optical illusion is when what your eyes perceive is different from reality due to the influence of various bits of information coming from the surroundings. Optical illusions affect many factors, such as the size, movement, color, brightness, and shape of an object. Optical illusions that cause your brain to deceive you. Don't believe everything you see. Niño's extinction illusion. In this picture of intersecting straight gray lines, there are 12 black dots. However, most people can't see all 12 points at once. When you focus on one point, the surrounding dots seem to disappear. But once you look to the side, the dot next to it appears. The reason is that our eyes do not have good peripheral vision. So when we focus on something, the brain makes a reasonable estimate of the object's surroundings. These four apples seem to get darker as they go to the right. However, in reality, they are all the same color. Since the gradient of the background gets lighter as it moves to the right, the brain corrects the perceived brightness of the apples, thereby creating an optical illusion. Do the orange circles at the center of each cluster of dots look about the same size? Here, the length of the horizontal straight lines is the same, but the bottom line looks longer. All the angles in this picture are formed by perfect squares, so all the lines are straight and parallel. We can't pinpoint the exact reason, but the lines look curved. There might be various reasons for optical illusions, but the most important reason is that our brain is efficient at processing information. Our brain tries to process visual information quickly and accurately with the limited information it receives. Light, which is the visual information that enters through the eyes, passes through the retina to the optic cortex through the optic nerve and onto the back of the brain, where the visual cortex lies. The visual cortex identifies things by cross-referencing the processed information with past memories stored in the brain. The brain tries to identify newly processed information by also referencing information from the past to be more efficient. It's at this point that the optical illusions are created. Artists and architects have been using optical illusions for thousands of years. For example, when ancient Greek architects designed pillars on a tall building, they made the end near the roof thinner, making the building look taller when viewed from below. The optical illusion known as forced perspective was used at various architectural sites, such as stages and gardens. This optical illusion was also used with the buildings on Main Street at Disneyland. The buildings on both sides of the road were created by reducing each floor by 1/8 of its size. The first floor is 3/4 of full size, second floor 5/8 of the size, and the third floor 1/2 of the size. The buildings also tilt slightly toward the castle. The distorted perspective makes the buildings look larger and the road appears longer so that the princess's castle at the end of the road seems farther away than it really is. Recently, several techniques using optical illusions have appeared in advertisements and movies. But humans are not the only ones to use optical illusion. Female great bowerbirds in Australia select their mating partner based on the nest created by the males. Therefore, males use optical illusions to make themselves appear larger in the female's eyes. Males arrange things like rocks and bones on the court leading away from the nest from smallest to largest. From the female's perspective within the nest, the arrangement of decorated rocks based on size creates that forced perspective optical illusion. The bigger stones in the distance look smaller, so the overall size of the rocks seems similar. Hence, when the female stands in the court, she perceives the size of the male to be larger than he actually is. Don't believe everything you see, because the truth can be totally different. Your eyes and brain can distort reality. Deception can come not only from the outside, but also from your own brain.